Look within.
Look within.
Look within.
And live your life. And live your life on the edge of two worlds. A reality where you find true understanding of who you are. Take the step into the unknown with Alexander McCaig and Jason Rigby as they explore the thinly veiled world of consciousness, spirit, and the human condition. Join them in embodying the oneness of all. Walk the cliff's edge between the seen and the unseen realities. Welcome to High Density Living.
Okay, little interjection there. We're back.
Yeah.
That'll be a harsh cut. It'll look good.
Yeah, it'll be good. We'll blame it on the dog.
Okay, so the...
not that he did anything on my floor kitchen.
Yeah, we'll blame the dog.
He got so fearful.
He got so scared we were going to slaughter him like the cow. Yeah. He's shitting himself inside the house.
Literally, yeah.
So the cow's gone off to auction, right?
Right.
It's been sold. Now this cow has to be transported, so they pack him into the trucks.
Right.
Cows are shitting themselves outside of the truck because they pack them into these huge, 18-wheelers. They get there. Now the cow has to get dressed and cut at the facility. But before that happens, they're crawled into a small area and they're put down with one of, multiple ways. Like I said, it was either an air gun, they electrically shock their brain until it stops, or they just blast them with a regular old rifle.
Right.
Just put the cow down.
Almost sounds like something you'd see in Nazi Germany.
To the cow, right? So we're going to corral people.
To the family of cows.
We're going to put you in confined spaces, and then we're just going to execute you in one of three ways.
Put you in cattle cars.
In cattle cars, exactly. So,
and we have been drinking, folks. You, on the other hand, have some crazy organic Amazon energy.
Organic Amazon.
I don't know if you're
energy.
Having like a plant base.
Yeah.
It's ayahuasca.
Yeah, it's just ayahuasca.
And then I have
just
your basic kombucha. There is a percentage of alcohol in there, isn't
there? Yeah, just a minor amount.
This is hibiscus ginger. This is going to make me
be
in touch with my feminine side.
No, that's good. You need that energy.
If I talk
about the cows any further, you know what I mean? So this cow now dies, right?
Right.
And before this cut off, I was telling the crowd, I was just speaking, that the energy of the cow, right, the state of fear, the cortisol that comes in during a fight or flight response, goes into the bloodstream, that adrenaline and the fear, right, that hormone, then goes into and sits within the muscle tissue of the cow.
Right.
So that fear, that shock, that tenseness physically causes the DNA structure of the cow to tighten up, right? Becomes very rigid. It's not flexible like it's supposed to be, right? It's that state of fear. So the energy signature, right, the vibration of that cow is very non-coherent.
Right.
Okay? It's just an erratic signature. Now, anything erratic, people don't like listening to erratic music.
No.
Most of us don't, right? Doesn't, when you talk to an erratic person, it doesn't make you feel
good.
No,
right.
So the cow's not feeling good with the erratic energy. Well, the cow's now dead, right? So it's dressed, cut up, and now they have to preserve this meat. This meat's now sprayed with a substance called ammonium nitrate. It keeps it nice and pink. All the supermarkets do it. There are other various forms of preserving this, but what you're doing is you're trying to take dead flesh of an animal, and you're trying to keep it for a shelf life long enough that it can actually get to the facility and then be sold, and then people can refrigerate that dead material further until they can cook it.
Right.
All right. And that entire time, there's been no change in that state of that material. All the same hormones, the cortisol, all the fear, all that chemical reaction that threw off that non-coherent energy is still sitting in that meat.
Well, I'll just put crystals around it.
So just put, cleanse it with crystals, right? Yeah. Put this one here. Cleanse the meat chakra. Yeah.
Put some quartz.
Yeah. Just slab, big slab.
Yeah, yeah. Then it'll be like
porterhouse on the
it'll
quartz.
It'll be a completely clear piece of meat.
Yeah, and then my crystal is just like tainted.
Yeah.
So that's the story. That's the cow, right? And then you cook it and then you ingest it.
Right, but I feel like instead of getting into the environment, we'll save that for the last.
We'll do that
last. I think now transition. We've ingested it.
Okay.
So what is happening to us?
Fantastic. That's a nice transition, right? So now we're going to ingest.
A bridge.
Yeah, we're going to make a bridge here.
Right.
Now we're going to ingest this meat.
Right.
Whether you ingest it raw.
Right.
Or you're going to cook it, or you keep it medium because you like a little bit of the blood.
Right.
There's a lot of different things happening. So on a chemical level, right? There are certain proteins that sit within inside the blood of the cow and the meat, right? And these proteins are carcinogenic to your body. So upon ingestion of this within a 24-hour period, right, in order for this to get out of your system, what it's doing is it's creating a correlation of, it binds the proteins in your blood together so it makes them thick, right? Doesn't make them very clear and slick like you'd want to have.
Right.
So the ingestion of the meat immediately when you start to bring it into your body from a chemical response is going to slow the blood flow. It's very heavy. It's going to take a long time to digest something like this, right? Now, your digestive tract is anywhere from 50 to 65 feet, right? It's really long. And it's about 3 to 4 times the length of animals that actually feed on meat, right? So meat-eating animals like Anubis here,
he has
to shit all the time because they have like about a 15-foot digestive tract.
Right.
And that's typical of a meat eater. But our digestive tract is designed to break down plant fibers. It's extremely long, right? So it gives it that time to work it and pull all the nutrients out until we've exhausted what was left of that plant as it moves through our body. But when we're eating the cow, right, or some form of meat, whatever it might be, not only are we ingesting proteins that the body doesn't want, right, we're also going to throw off the gut bacteria in our body. So the bacteria that the cows actually hold within their meat when you're eating it, right, after it's been transported and sit and you cooked any way you want, it's going to kill off the good flora that sits inside of your gut. That's not fantastic because this is your second brain.
Right.
And a majority of your health actually comes from this area.
And they've realizing that emotions and your hormone levels and all that stuff are coming from that.
So then you start to realize, okay, so because I'm ingesting dead meat, right? If I'm ingesting something that
fear-based,
right? That was killed in a state of fear. Now it's going to throw off my gut biome.
Right.
And the energy of that cow, the physical energy signature of what was going on with that dead meat is now going to throw off my energy signature as a person. So my hormones, I'm going to feel up and down. I'm going to be erratic. I'm going to feel that same sort of non-coherence that the cow actually felt.
And we have, you know, antidepressants as being one of the number one things that are, you know, being prescribed.
Yeah.
We have people that are, you know, I mean, like now we're making, you know, like meals around the piece of meat.
Yeah.
Not just a part of the meal.
Correct.
Or a small part of it.
No, and the issue is that it is the focus, right?
Right.
But that focus, every time you eat it, you think, oh, protein's the benefit. Well, it's not really the benefit. You get a shitload more protein from eating your vegetables.
Yeah, exactly.
Right? And tons of complex carbs. Eating the cow does you actually no service whatsoever, right? All it's going to do is actually harm your body. It's very difficult for your body to digest. You can't digest it properly. Mm. And it destroys all the natural equilibrium that your body actually wants to hold.
Right.
Right? So that's what happens when we're ingesting it. And that's the biggest problem. And there's also a 27% correlation to coronary heart disease.
Right.
So hardening of your arteries in your heart just from eating meat itself.
Is the same. Let me ask you this, Alex. So whenever because I want to get into this because I have a lot of people and I ask them right off the bat like you did. You do. It's like, how are you feeling emotionally?
Mm.
You know, how are you feeling spiritually? Where do you feel like you're at? And then you start talking to them a while and then you're like, well, don't eat meat for a couple weeks and see how you feel.
Right.
You know, I mean, I think it needs to be longer than 2 weeks. I think it needs to be at least... Because 2 weeks is going to go through a process.
That's like the J curve. You're at the bottom in 2 weeks.
And then that week, see how you feel the third week.
Yeah.
And then if you feel amazing in that third week. But like for me, what I really noticed was the balancing of my emotions.
That's correct.
Where I wasn't getting as pissed off so quickly. You know, I mean, me being in leadership and having to deal with, you know, constant barrages and people coming in and stuff. It was when I'm eating and I feel that heaviness.
Right.
You know, it's almost like...
There's no lightness to your energy.
No, there's no... It's negative, dark. It's you know, super ego-driven.
There's a lot of gravity to it,
yes.
Right? There's just so much weight to, like, the decision and everything you're doing. There's no lightness or airiness or flow to life, right?
Right?
You can't feel that flow. And remember, if you look back at our episode of The Crystal World, eating that cow has a liquid crystalline structure, okay? So liquid crystals have a certain vibrational pattern. So if that's non-coherent, right, and I'm absorbing that crystal into my liquid crystal structure, that is going to throw off the coherence of my body. So my emotions, how I feel, all those different things are going to be affected from eating that dead animal, right? That energy that's associated with it.
And imagine if what would happen, you know, like for me, I'm testifying to this.
Sure.
If you stop eating meat and your emotions get balanced and you feel amazing and you go back to eating meat, it's almost like you're just doing something out of ignorance.
You are doing it out of ignorance because you know that something is making you feel better. And all the facts are in front of you to tell you that you shouldn't be doing something like that, but you choose to ignore it.
Yeah, and I think that's the biggest thing is that there's a lot of people that will choose not to, because we're questioning everything now.
I think
in this society, we should.
It's important. And people should question this video and what we do. And we urge them to look at those facts and we'll put the research online for them. That's
fine. For 46 years, I ate meat all the time. I'm from the South. That's what we did. So why couldn't I listen for 3 weeks out of 46 years.
That's right.
And just try it and see what happens.
Don't knock it until you try it.
Right.
And what would you do? You persevered. You tried it for 3 weeks of the entire culmination of your life. Right. And how do you feel?
Now I'm like, what, almost 2 months into it.
Right.
And, you know, I feel amazing. And I do not have a desire. And I feel better because I know I'm not being a part of a system. We're going to have the next video on this. But I feel like I'm not being part of a system that propagates the ability to mass produce something that is killing.
Right. And that's a separate system. Right. That'll be the systems thinking part of the video, right?
Yeah.
And we're not trying to be evangelical about this to say that, you know, stop eating meat, you know, blah, blah, blah. All I ask is that you sit down and you question for a moment the habits that you've been doing, right? Mm-hmm. Blindly, right? Just from, okay, so society does this and this is what I'm used to, but is that the correct thing to do, right? Just, you know, and you could say that for a million other things that happen.
Oh, yeah.
Life,
I mean,
right?
How much Oreos am I eating at night?
But this is a simple example.
Or Twinkies. Or,
right.
Yeah.
But the thing is, you know, and how is it that you can show, let's say, well, I'm respectful of other people and other things when you're not respecting your own body?
Right.
And to ingest something that has a spirit, that had a life, that took a very long time for it to grow to the size that it was at, and to end its life just so you can ingest it for, what, 15 minutes of, you know, enjoyment in a societal act for something that we're just commonplace for us?
Right.
What's the benefit? Well, there isn't. Because physiologically, socially, emotionally, and systemically, and environmentally, none of those things benefit anybody.
Yeah, and I think the way I look at it, especially when you're looking at being selfish in that, but when we look at ourselves and we look at this issues that we have where we almost, it's like, you know, a lot of people make jokes like our pets eat better than we do, or they have better diets than we do, or we take care of our children more than we do.
Okay.
I think it gets back to, if we can't, like you said, if we can't respect ourselves first and understand who we truly are inside of ourselves,
how are you going to respect anybody else?
You can't. I mean, I've come to that conclusion, and I think it's truth. And correct me if I'm wrong, but if I literally cannot understand who I am and that I'm a part of all and that what is all is in me.
Correct.
Then when I'm looking at myself and I want to be negative and I want to eat shitty food and I want to do harm and I want to, because basically you're harming yourself.
You're harming yourself.
And I want to harm myself. And then I turn around and say, I love this person. I do everything for my child, or I do, you know, everything for this or that. How can that, none of that is based on truth.
No, it's that, then it becomes a hypocritical act.
Yes.
Quite frankly, it's a hypocritical act to say that I can respect and do the best things for this child. You can't do the best for yourself.
Right.
So how is it that if you're not doing the absolute best for yourself, how can then you choose to do the absolute best for somebody else?
Right.
What is that? That'd be a lot of martyrs in this world, right?
But when you can look at somebody and you can say, we had this conversation yesterday at we went to a Thai vegan place.
Yeah.
We've turned this into two videos, but
yeah,
we went to Thai vegan. But when you can really look at somebody and say, you know, I'm working on myself in the sense of understanding who I am. And through the reflection of that, now I'm beginning to understand what a relationship is.
Right. Because you're teaching yourself how to understand. That's
you're teaching
the thing.
Yourself almost what love is.
Yeah.
And then it's just organically propagating out.
Well, isn't that how...
To everyone.
Isn't that how they think the best universities work?
Right.
So you go into that university, right? And you learn, so that when you graduate, you propagate that information, you become a betterment to society.
Right.
So why don't you apply that same model to how you function with everything else in your life, right? Mm-hmm. Look at yourself. Sit down in your own classroom, focus on these pieces of you, right? And realize that what I'm doing, this act, right, needs to be changed because all my other actions are hypocritical. They're counterintuitive to what I'm choosing here.
And the reason they're hypocritical is this, because I've experienced this, and this is so cool. When you're sitting across the table from somebody and you have got to the point in your life, I mean, we'll always be learning and teaching, but you've got to the point where you're sitting there saying, I've worked through this. I've worked through this part. I've worked through this part. Let's name the parts. I've worked through the fear part. Mm-hmm. I've worked through the jealousy part.
All right.
I've worked through the anger part. I've worked through the...
Hate
part. I've worked through the loss, experiencing loss. And then I've done all that. And so now, right now, in this moment,
yeah,
with this person, I'm looking at them And I'm honestly loving them through that whole process.
Correct.
Because I've worked on myself that I can sit at a table and not be a hypocrite and look across the table. Do you know how fucking good that feels?
Oh, it feels amazing, right?
Because you're like, oh, okay, this is how it's supposed to be when you're with another person.
The conversation changes, the dynamic changes. You respect the things that are now outside of you, right? So then when you look at that cheeseburger, it's no different from that other person.
Right.
Because now you got to respect, well, what is it that I'm actually eating?
Do I want the short-term gains?
Yes.
Do I want the ego-driven fulfillment?
Demeaning other person.
And then I'm going to take in my brain and tease my brain in a hypocritical way because I really want this cheeseburger.
Yeah.
So I'm going to play all these games in my head to justify it.
Yeah.
It's the same as relationship.
That's all it is.
So, and then I'm going to guilt myself. And then after I'm going to eat it, enjoy it. Mm-hmm. And then afterwards, I'm going to feel shitty.
No one, and guilty.
No one feels great after leaving. You see those people like where they can barely walk when they come out of a restaurant? I used to be that way.
Yeah.
You know, like Longhorn Steakhouse or something.
I'm just going to gorge on this.
I'm going to have a big, huge mashed potatoes, tons of mac and cheese.
Yeah. And it just doesn't make
sense. And then I want the 21-ounce ribeye, you know.
Listen, you know,
and you come literally out of there like your body is like, what the hell did you do to me?
Listen, I'm not a saint, a god, or a guru, right?
Right.
I've been there.
Yeah.
Okay? I just realized it a while ago.
That garlic butter is badass.
Garlic butter is really good. Yes.
You can have the garlic.
I can have the garlic.
And the oat, or what is it?
Vegan butter, I'll do.
Yeah, Can you do vegan butter with garlic?
Yeah, why not? Yeah, I can make that no problem. Oscar style.
Yeah.
But the point is, right, that respect, once you can respect yourself, then you can start to respect other things.
Right.
But when you're choosing to eat that meat, right, that is not respecting your body for what it is, that temple, that frankly, that divine energy that has formed you.
Right.
Your body's frankly, it's a fucking miracle. The fact that you can walk, talk, eat, think, breathe, rationalize certain things.
There's no AI, there's no quantum computer that they can invent that even can do 1/10 of the percent. Our eyes alone.
Right. Your eyes alone, the optical nerve is that amazing, right?
That 3D imaging that we can process in milliseconds.
That's correct. And so, you know, when you look at the majesty for what every single individual person in yourself is.
And that cow,
right? Because it's amazing that the cow is what the cow is.
You're pointing to all the...
And I'm pointing here, guys, and I know you're like, what's he pointing at? There's pictures of cows.
I literally have... Well, I've had like multiple people tell me I look like a cow. So I don't know if I was like reincarnated in a cow before, but people say like I'm like a cow.
I didn't even know that.
Yeah, I mean, I kind of look like one, I guess. Kind of like bigger.
And the long tongue that just licks and stuff. Yeah. I don't want any
But I have like new photos we just unraveled that's going. And then I have one, two, three, four, five, probably like five. And then those.
This is like a cow.
It's like a cow.
It's a cowspiracy.
And I've always liked cows. Yeah. I mean, I used to eat them all the time.
I mean, that's weird. I love cows, but I want to eat them, right?
Yeah.
So how do you actually love something if you can't respect its life?
Mm, yeah, that's a good point.
No, so like this dog that's sitting here.
Right. He's blending into the carpet.
There's no difference. So, you know, and Amanda made a fantastic point, right?
Right.
This is what she said. This dog, if I were to stand here and shoot it in the face, put the dog down, kill it, dress its body, cook it and eat it, people would claim me as a psychopath.
Right.
But it's okay if I walk out to a field and I put a cow down, cut it up, dress it and eat it. Why? Because our perspective, our distortion of society says that's okay.
Yeah.
But I'm a psychopath if I put this dog down? So what's the defining difference between both of these things?
Yeah, what's the difference between a dog and a cow and...
If I spent enough time with a cow, I would assume it had some sort of personality too.
Or a spider or vice versa, yeah.
But we're so disassociated from it, right? And I think that's frankly, that's a shame.
Yeah, it is.
I think and there's something I want to touch on. So when I said that when you ingest the cow, right, the vibrational frequency of that cow, that non-coherence, how it changes your vibrational frequency, I want you to consider this as a metaphor, guys. So when you take a drop of water and you throw it in a pond that's very still, it ripples for some time, right? Mm-hmm. The equilibrium state of that pond is disrupted.
Right.
Until those ripples then fall into equilibrium. And that takes a length of time. And that's just one little portion, that's one little drop. But when you're eating the cow, that's a massive drop coming into a very large piece of body. So for the amount of time that it's disrupting your crystalline structure is for, you know, a huge chunk of non-coherence that you don't want. So you're going to feel that indigestion, right? That discomfort, that emotional instability, right? You're actually going to feel a little bit of what the cow felt, just in some other fashion, right? You don't feel it directly, but you feel the ripple effects. And I think, I hope that happens. I hope that works as a little bit of a metaphor.
But I mean, to close, I think this would be perfect too, because if all of us as little pebbles on this environment, we're fixing to talk about that. This environment, if we
eat. Fixing. Fixing. I remember. Yeah.
Oh, Lord. That's my southern roots, bro.
Oh, man.
I'm from South Georgia, Florida.
I'm fixing to kill some cows, man. I'm just fixing for it, you know? I'm fixing for a T-bone steak.
Yeah, I'm fixing, yeah. My I gotta get goodness. That. Dude, I got like so many words that are, I say gosh darn sometimes.
Gosh darn fixing gosh at darn the end of the day.
Oh, it's so funny. So I need some grit, some eggs and ham.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, hush puppies, all that other good stuff.
All that stuff. So, no, but seriously, so you don't eat meat, I don't eat meat, a lot of us come together, not in some stupid judgmental way, like this whole vegan movement's been happening, it seems like, these fundamentalists, you know, but we all come together, and we start dropping into that water of the society that we're going to talk about here in a few minutes. Mm-hmm. Now, how many ripples are we creating?
Oh my God, a massive amount of ripples, right? And then it becomes very difficult to even calculate where those ripples are going to go.
Right.
So from sense of physics, right? So if physicists have a hard time understanding where after the second contact of two, if the cue ball hits one of the balls, right? And it hits another one, beyond that second contact, it becomes very hard to calculate the direction of where something's going to go. The probabilities just become too wide, right? It becomes very difficult to understand that angle. So when you're talking about society making all these actions, all these people eating cheeseburgers, so how is that ripple effect going to happen? Where does it go? Where does that erratic energy go, right? There's no direct path. There's no real understanding of what's going to happen, right? So it's all this non-coherent energy that just spreads and spreads and spreads, and these ripples then become waves. And these waves are what we see in the news that cause all these problems, right? You see the health issues, right? Or issues with land, or issues with water, or issues with soil, right? Or issues with carbon dioxide, carbon footprint, all that stuff. And I think we'll move into that in the next episode. Mm-hmm. But what we want to do is we want to calm those ripples, right?
Right.
We want to take the storm and we just want to move it into gentle waves. And then from the gentle waves, we want to calm, totally serene lake.
And in the serene lake, we want to make sure tonight's episode is sponsored by, should we be the USDA?
Yeah. The USDA has sponsored tonight's episode. Cattle Ranchers of America.
Yeah. Yes. That's who's sponsoring tonight. Yeah.
Thank you, everyone.
I think it's important. You know, like we don't judge any of it.
No.
People, and I think that's something that's like, I don't eat meat and you do. That's horrific. You're, you know, killing things. But at the end of the day, everybody has their own, I don't want to say demons, but we all have our own things that we're going through in our lives. So everyone's, how can I look at, if you're eating meat and I'm not, how can I look at you as a lesser being?
You can't.
Right.
All you got to understand is that, guess what? It's either one, I'm ignorant to the facts.
Okay? Right.
And I'm not saying ignorance in like a demeaning way. Ignorance is just, you just don't know.
Yeah.
Right? You just don't know.
Right.
Right? You're not educated.
I like
on
Cheetos.
It. Okay, cool.
Right.
That, or you know the facts and you choose to ignore it.
Right.
Okay? So that's one of two things. So when you look at that, you've got to be wondering, it's like, well, the person's not the other, it's just their choice. So it's either you learn it now or you learn it later.
Right.
Whether you learn it at this moment or you learn it in the hospital during cardiac arrest. It's like, what choice do you want? You know?
But I don't want people getting, especially, you know, like that people that watch this and then all of a sudden they have this great epiphany and then they stop eating meat and then they run around and they turn into these little fundamentalists.
Well, yeah. So
that's what we want to prevent.
Yeah, we don't want that. I know it's exciting, right? And you get excited. But understand that it's not for you to impress or tell people how they should live their lives.
This is important.
It's important that you educate yourself, right? And you speak with the honesty of the things that work for you. And if somebody wants to pick up on that information, if they want to learn from you and I about the journey we've taken and the choices we made and the benefits we've perceived, well, then that's for them to try at that point. But they're no lesser than us, right?
No.
They're no different than us if they choose to continue to eat meat.
And then putting these, like, I'm a vegan tribe, or I'm a plant-based tribe, or I'm a carnivore.
Because then you're judging and you put people in a box. And when you do that, you create the other, right? And just remember, everyone is a reflection of everyone else, right?
Right.
We're all but fractals in this giant universe, and we all came from the same place.
I would be concerned when you have, like, I know carnivore, the chicks would be that hot in that. Paleo, they may be actually pretty hot. Yeah, yeah. Vegans,
I don't know about that. Vegans got
great. They look really pale.
Yeah. I don't know if they're getting enough
iron. We're digressing here. Yeah. But, I'm trying to think of, like, what tribal culture, plant-based, they're vibrant.
Yeah.
They would be
very vibrant. Yeah, yeah. Right.
Have but great skin.
and that's the problem, right? People are so like, they don't want to touch it because it has a label on it.
Right.
Right? And that goes for everything. So
I do CrossFit and I'm paleo.
Well, think about it. You go to the store. Right. I don't like the label on that brand. I'm not going to buy it.
Right.
It's the same damn thing. Mm-hmm. Right? So just remove the label and just accept it for what it is. Right? We're not being evangelical. We're not proclamating something. We're just saying exactly what's happening. We're sharing our journey with people, and we're just looking at the facts.
Well, label's external anyways.
Label's totally external.
And then everything's internally inside of you.
Yeah.
So when you begin to label yourself or say you're this or that, you're going external.
You're going external. And then you start to say things that are the other. Mm-hmm. Well, hold on a second. This dog eats food that came from the same soil that I'm eating food came from the same soil. We're all ingesting the same stuff, and we're all just borrowing this material to accumulate these physical bodies.
Yeah, exactly.
Simple as that.
And he's eating my rug.
Is he?
No. There's probably like food in there.
He's sniffing the dog food. Yeah.
There's all kinds of stuff in there.
Yeah.
He's like, guys, I was having so much fun down here.
Good boy. But guys, we hope you enjoy that. We hope that made a little bit of sense from the fact of the lifespan of the cow, how it has to grow, what it does, and the point of where its life is ended abruptly without its choice. Okay. Right. It doesn't die naturally. And then the fact that you take this thing that didn't have a natural cause and you ingest it to make yourself naturally feel better, right? When in fact, those things have massive negative effects that outweigh anything positive you might receive from it.
And then what's happening, we went heavily into what's happening inside of you.
Inside of you, right?
And then how it distributes out to others.
Right, and how not respecting yourself and saying that you can respect others can't happen.
Perfect, and we're going to have another video that's going to talk about what is happening to the environment.
Right. We'll look at it from a systems thing, and I'll walk you through the entire train of this, and I'll show you how interconnected it is and how difficult it is and amazing that a burger can make it on a plate and into your mouth.
That's awesome. Well, thank you guys.
Thanks, guys.
Look within, and live your life on the edge of two worlds, a reality where you find true understanding of who you are. The learning is done. Become the teacher in embodying the oneness of all. Walk the cliff's edge between the seen and the unseen realities. Become a higher density being. Please go to www.higherdensityliving.com.